I've suffered from depression and anxiety for most of my adult life. It's not easy to talk about, but women like Carrie Fisher made it a hell of a lot easier. Carrie was a lot of things: a princess, a general, a rebel, a star. On the big screen, she loomed larger than life, a total badass who talked back to Darth Vader without fear.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a member of the Imperial Senate on a diplomatic mission to Alderaan.
You are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take her away!
For young girls not used to seeing women take starring roles in sci-fi or fantasy epics fighting the bad guys, she was incredibly refreshing. And she continues to be. In The Last Jedi, she's in her most badass portrayal yet, showing why she's in charge of the Resistance, teaching younger, male trigger-happy pilots all sorts of life lessons, and giving us even more iconic looks. But off-screen, she loomed even larger, staring down life's own dark side without fear, and with a healthy dose of wit, candor, and one-of-a-kind humor. It was those character traits that made her seem so relatable and likable despite her superstardom. Here's what you need to know about depression. Depression is a liar. It tricks you into thinking that you deserve to be miserable or that you don't deserve to be happy. The way that Carrie spoke about her own struggles with bipolar disorder was so candid, so bracing, and often so hilarious that you couldn't help but laugh. And that almost immediately made you feel better.
I think if you're manic depressed and you're living with it, it takes balls, or the female equivalent. And, you know, it's people make fun of it or don't want anyone to know. Man, I don't care.
One of the greatest dangers of mental illness is how isolating it is. You might feel like no one else can understand you or relate to you. Even the most well-meaning person who has nothing but love for you can make an offhand comment that seems dismissive, and it'll make you want to retreat back into a safe zone, closed off from other people. I don't think Carrie believed in safe zones. In her interviews, in her writing, in her tweets, it's very clear that she cares little what any haters might have to say. She lived her life. Mental illness can feel like a prison, but Carrie seemed to live freely and openly. And she was very, very honest about the traps that she fell into, drugs that definitely ended up hurting more than they helped. Of course, she wasn't perfect. Nobody is. But her seeming ease with that is what made her so inspiring. When everyone else was striving for a very inhuman kind of perfection, she was there, likely with her adorable dog, Gary, not giving two shits what anybody thought. Here's something that she tweeted when The Force Awakens first came out, and people were judging how she had aged. In my opinion, very gracefully. She said, "Youth and beauty are not accomplishments. They're the temporary happy byproducts of time and/or DNA. Don't hold your breath for either." As a woman who works in news and media, the pressure that I feel to look or weigh a certain way can be debilitating to my confidence, on top of general anxiety I already feel. Look down, I'm sure somebody said something negative in the comments already. But for a woman who worked in Hollywood, the most intense pressure cooker for body confidence there could ever be, to talk so frankly and give the internet a middle finger for judging her at all, it was nothing short of exhilarating. I really need to get that tweet framed. It's rare to see a high-profile woman, especially one with such a massive platform, be as open and honest as Carrie Fisher was. It's rare to see any kind of successful woman, period, admit that they have internal conflicts. But what she taught us to do is accept that, and to accept ourselves. When she passed away, I saw countless people summon their Carrie-inspired courage and talk about being bipolar, or being depressed, or other illnesses. Why is there still such a stigma around it? Some 43 million American adults live with it. One of the ways that we get better is simple. But it can be terrifying. Talk about it. Recognize it for what it is. Part of you, but not all of you. Accept yourself. Carrie certainly never backed down from that challenge.
May the Force be with you.